Rooster was shot in the shoulder and neck area and died very quickly after being shot.
And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking.
Well, good afternoon, everybody. My name is Gordon Ramsey. I'm the Wichita Police Chief. And I'd like to thank you all for attending this memorial service for the first canine killed in our department's history. I'd also like to thank Mayor Longwell, city councilors, and other elected officials that are here today, as well as City Manager Layton. Thank them for attending, as well as their strong support of our department. So while this is a very sad and tragic event that brings us here today, it has been heartwarming to see the local and national support in the loss of Rooster. And the support has deeply touched members of our department. Rooster's handler, Officer Daniel Gum, and members of the Wichita Police Department are very thankful for all of the cards, the messages, and kind comments on the street given in Rooster's memory. On behalf of our department and city, I want to express our sincere condolences to Officer Gum in the death of his beloved partner, Rooster. And I also want everybody to know that police dogs are not only a member of the police department, but they're also a member of their handler's family. So, you know, we also want Officer Gum's wife, Amber, and their children, Jacob, Madison, and Callie, to know we realize this is an equally tough time for them as you mourn the loss of Rooster. I'd like to introduce our police chaplain, the director of our chaplains, Pastor Dave Henyon. Pastor Dave, as he is affectionately known by, he's been a volunteer chaplain with the WPD for 23 years and is there at every time we need him, he is there. So, Pastor Dave, I will hand this over to you. Thank you.
Well, I too want to express my sadness to Daniel and his family, especially in the loss of his partner. But I also want to highlight the beauty of what God has provided for us. The first thing I want to remind us of is that God has given us creation. And when he brought creation to existence, man was the supreme person to run it. He had dominion over the animals, the fish, and everything. And God had a special thing for mankind in that he gave mankind dogs. And they're beautiful creatures, and we have learned over the years how they can be effective tools as God wants them to be to support, to encourage us and give us what we need. I have a friend in Michigan who had a problem living on Lake Michigan. There were people who would run in his backyard and go on the lake and swim when he had all kinds of trespassing signs put up. And he owned a large corporation, and he was wondering what he could do, electronic surveillance, all kinds of things. And one night they came upon, him and his wife came upon the most effective thing they could do to prevent and help save those who had drowned in his backyard, literally. And what they did is they bought a dog, a Labrador Retriever, and they named him Help. And every time somebody would break through their yard and go and swim and get themselves into trouble, even when they were watching TV, or they were asleep, when people were yelling for help, they would get up, call 911, and run out and try to save the person that was drowning. God has blessed us with dogs, and especially Rooster, and for the team of canines that serve our community and the communities around us. We're super blessed. In fact, I know a little girl, one of the officers' daughters in the department, who struggles and has diabetes. And that dog, because of its senses and the way it's been trained, alerts the family when she's in trouble with her diabetes. God's given us dogs to help us. And Rooster, we are so grateful for what he's done. But we all know, today we're here to give thanks for Rooster's life, and to remember him because he did a noble thing. We live in this world that's fallen, and every day we have hundreds of calls go through our 911 switchboard, and brave men and women, and also our canines, respond to homes of people that they've never met because people can dial three numbers, and they'll have these strangers come and put their lives down for them. And we're so grateful for that. And because of this fallen world, though, there are people who do many strange things, whether well-meaning or not well-meaning or even hateful, because we live in this fallen world. But I am grateful that we have people and dogs that go into the fire and try to prevent people from getting hurt. I'm a pastor in a Christian religion, and one of the great things that we know, the Bible tells us, that our Lord went to the cross, took the hit for us, so that we could have eternal life, that we can live. And we're reminded here today of the nobleness that Rooster did that night when he went on that call. He went into that home, and there were other officers that if Rooster had not been there, I wonder what would have happened to those officers. Would one of them have been shot? I know right now we have a man, one of our officers, laying in a hospital in Colorado, trying to recover from the nastiness of someone hatefully, trying to prevent themselves from being arrested and running over one of our officers. And I wonder what would have happened if Rooster wasn't there that night. But I am grateful that Rooster was able to go in there and take the hit for our guys. He should be honored. That's what we're doing here. And I pray for Dan, for his family, that knew Rooster, were close, and cared about him. And I know Dan had a special relationship with that partner of his, but I am also grateful that God had given us Rooster to walk in the fear and through the fear and through the problems so that we could get that situation resolved. And today I would like to just say a prayer, giving thanks for Rooster and also for the family and their bereavement. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, today I come to you with gratitude on our hearts because of your provision that man could think and find ways in which we could have dogs help us in this life and that you provided for them, whether it is through their sense of smell, find a child that's lost, or through the sense of smell being able to detect drugs, or charging into a situation that is highly volatile and protecting our officers from having to get bodily harm themselves. And today we pay honor to Rooster, who did that very thing, who put himself in the line of fire so that we could have peace and justice in this land and that our officers could be safe. Lord, bless the Gum family. Bless Daniel and the grief that they share because of the closeness, the many hard work times they spent together and the situations they worked, and that you'll bless them. Bless our department and all those men and women who put their lives on the line every day in this city and in the county and throughout the state and through this country to keep the society from becoming anarchy. Lord, bless us now, and we give you thanks for Rooster. And through Jesus Christ, I pray this. Amen.
All right, thanks, Pastor Dave, Chief, Executive Staff, Mr. Mayor, the City Manager, all the City Council members, my family, all the K-9 teams from around the region. I'm sure everybody got to see them on your way in. All the my brothers and sisters in law enforcement, SWAT, honored guests. The support that we've gotten from the community is overwhelming. There's been more cards and phone calls and donations than you would ever even imagine. I wouldn't expect that this much support from the community, and it's appreciated. I'm sure you can tell, not much of a public speaker, so I'm gonna keep it pretty short. Rooster was born in Holland, January 25th, 2011. Got imported to the United States in April of 2012, where I was lucky enough to go down and assist with selecting him for service here in Wichita. Came back and completed a 10-week basic training program and hit the street with him as a patrol dog team in August 9th of 2012. Rooster was, anyone that was around him knows, he is an extremely highly driven dog. He would try to take control of anything or anyone every chance that he got. After a period of feeling out between the two of us, Finally settled in and started to really kind of gel as a team. Unfortunately, that wasn't until earlier this year. It only took about 4 years. Throughout the time that I had Rooster, we trained for over 3,000 hours, seized 256 pounds of marijuana, 10 pounds of meth, over $31,000 in U.S. currency, had over 35 apprehensions with and without contact, more than 25 SWAT deployments, some more impressive than others, over 50 tracks and 100 building searches. It's pretty amazing what we can teach these dogs to do and what they'll do for us without any hesitation at all and more conviction than any person ever could. So, as I said, Rooster, he was a patrol dog, he wasn't an officer. Kind of like Pastor Dave said, this would have been a far different ceremony had it been an officer, and that's what these dogs are for, and quite honestly, I owe my life to him. So he was not an officer, but at the same time, he was my partner every day. Other officers, when they go out to work, they may get paired up with their beat buddy, someone else who works in the same area on the same shift, someone they went to the academy with. So when I went to work, every day, Rooster was my partner. We very, very rarely get anyone else ride with us. So with that, we hear a lot, you know, hey, that must be cool. You have a dog riding with you. So it is. You know, that's plain and simple. It's pretty cool to have a dog riding around with you. But it's also like having a two-year-old riding with you. A very stinky, hyper, panting, slobbering, 80-pound two-year-old with really bad gas. Rooster in particular, every time we'd turn a corner, he would let me know that he was still back there. I don't think I've taken a drink since 2009 when I became a handler, when I was at work where I didn't have, you know, some hair or slobber come along with it. So, even with all that, all the gas and the panting and all of that stuff, I wouldn't trade it for anything. It's difficult to explain the bond that you have with your dog, especially when you're put in life-threatening situations, like truly life-threatening situations, and you're depending on that dog. Even more so if you're lucky enough to deploy with the SWAT team. You have a whole team of guys wanting to know, hey, what's your dog telling you? It's a pretty serious deal. But the SWAT thing, that's where Rooster, he embraced that role. He was a hard dog. He liked to go handle business. And I'm grateful for our opportunity to work with those guys. That's where his heart was at, and that's where he excelled. Powerful dog, powerful bite, and he didn't know anything except for all in. He was go and stop. There wasn't anything in between. There's a few felons and unfortunately one state trooper in the area that can vouch for that. He was all in. Unfortunately, you know, he got shot and killed. Fortunately, it was fast, and fortunately he was there to do that, to take that role for us. I can take solace in that. I mean, he truly died what he loved to do, doing what he loved to do. He loved it. I'm here today because that dog was there, and because the guys that I work with were there too. So that's all I got. Thanks everybody for showing up, and again, thanks for all the cards and plaques, flowers, everything. We really appreciate it.
Thank you. Present. Up.
Please all rise for the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance of his kindness be upon you and give you peace now and forever. Amen. Congregation is dismissed.